For the purposes of this lab, we're looking specifically at operational amplifiers in closed-loop configurations, where a portion of the amplifier output signal is fed back into the input signal. In this configuration, the gain of the amplifier can be precisely controlled and even altered during operation. Open-loop amplifiers do have incredibly high gain, but their usefulness is limited in electronics, as the output of an open-loop amplifier is saturated so easily. Minute differences in the manufacturing process mean that gain properties of op-amps are similar, but not completely identical. Without feedback from the output, these small differences become very large, making the output of an open-loop op-amp unpredictable. The addition of the feedback resistor allows the gain of the op-amp to be controlled and calculated. In the inverting amplifier circuit depicted, overall voltage gain can be easily calculated using this formula: ACL equals negative RF over RIN, where ACL represents the closed loop gain. That means if RIN is 1K and RF is 10K, the voltage gain of the circuit will be negative 10. If the input voltage is 0.1 volt, then the output voltage will be negative 1 volt. The gain of the amplifier can now be predictably controlled by manipulating these resistor values. Most used operational amplifiers are the most widely used analog integrated circuit. Some applications, such as comparators, do not require closed-loop feedback as part of their function, but for most use cases, the gain of the op-amp must be controlled. In these instances, some form of output feedback is required. An important advantage of negative feedback in an op-amp circuit is that the specific voltage gain of the op-amp is no longer critical in determining the gain of the circuit. An op-amp only amplifies the difference between the inverting and non-inverting inputs. Negative feedback can reduce the difference between them to negligible values. In the circuit shown, for practical purposes, the output voltage is equal to the non-inverting input voltage. The precise op-amp gain does not have to be set by the factory in order to design an amplifier with precise gain. The negative feedback will make the system self-correcting. Op-amp amplifiers are used in many different types of circuits and in many different configurations, but there are a few standard configurations. The differential amplifier does what its name suggests. It amplifies the difference in voltage between its inputs. The inverting amplifier is a special type of differential amplifier in which the non-inverting input of the op-amp is grounded and the inverting input serves as Vin. The voltage follower, or unity buffer amplifier, is used to connect a device with high source impedance to a device with low input impedance. The instrumentation amplifier combines properties such as low DC offset, very high input impedance, and high common mode rejection, which is the rejection by the device of unwanted input signals common to both input leads. This combination makes this amplifier ideal for accurate, low noise measurements.